Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. There is a scene in the Christmas classic, It's a Wonderful Life, where the Jimmy Stewart character asks his Uncle Billy, "You know what the three most beautiful sounds in the world are?" And Uncle Billy replies, "Breakfast is served, lunch is served, dinner is served." "No, no," Jimmy Stewart replies. "The three most beautiful sounds in the world are anchor chains, airplane engines, and train whistles." For Jimmy Stewart's character, the idea of travel, of going all over the world, visiting many different places, that was his dream. That was his dream. That was something exhilarating to him. That's how he wanted to spend much of his life, on a journey. And the journey is one of the most compelling and captivating themes in human life. Think of all the great stories that have focused on journeys, like from ancient Greece, the Odyssey, with Ulysses journeying home from the Trojan War. Or from Spain, Don Quixote, where the knight and his squire Sancho travel all over Spain, righting wrongs and occasionally fighting windmills. Or from 19th century America, Moby Dick, where the whaler, the Pequod, travels across the world seeking the great white whale. Or three novels from modern America, As I Lay Dying, where Faulkner's southern family journeys home to lay their mother to rest. Or The Grapes of Wrath, where displaced Oklahoma farmers set out for greener pastures in California. Or On the Road, where Jack Kerouac's beatnik characters journey across America. And lots of real-life journeys in our country's history. Somebody mentioned Lewis and Clark after the first service. And you can think of all the pioneers who went west seeking land and new opportunity. And a lot of music, too, a lot of great songs that celebrate the road. Nat King Cole urged us to get our kicks on Route 66. Bob Dylan talked about all the interesting things that happened on Highway 61. Willie Nelson exults in the joy of being on the road again. And there's a song about Willie by Billy Joe Shaver that says this: "Willie, he tells me all the doers and thinkers say moving is the closest thing to being free." Moving is the closest thing to being free. What a great line that is. Maybe that's why the road captivates us so much. It represents freedom. That's kind of actually what Paul is telling us in our reading from Philippians today. "Forgetting what is behind and straining toward what lies ahead, I press on. I press on." He keeps moving forward in his life. Paul sees life as a journey toward heaven, and he keeps moving down that road. So for him, moving is being free, pressing on toward the heaven that God has prepared for us. You know, people sometimes wonder why Jesus was born when he was. And I actually have my confirmation classes memorized. Four reasons why Jesus was born when he was. And one of those reasons is transportation. The Romans had built a great system of roads. They also had made the Mediterranean safe for travel by putting down piracy. So traveling was pretty easy in the time of Jesus. And St. Paul took full advantage of those great Roman roads and that safe Mediterranean sea. He journeyed all over the Roman Empire, hundreds and hundreds of miles, carrying the good news about Jesus to people all over the place. St. Paul was a road guy long before Jack Kerouac. St. Paul was on the road. In fact, that is where he found Jesus. He found Jesus on the road to Damascus, when he was going there to persecute Christians. And a bright light flashed and blinded him, and he heard the voice of Jesus speak, and St. Paul became a servant of Jesus at that moment, on the road. So St. Paul spent a lot of his life on the road. But when he writes Philippians, he was in prison. He was in chains. He couldn't move very much. This man who lived on the road, this man who traversed the wonderful roads of the Roman Empire and traveled across the sea, now he could do nothing but pace in a little prison cell. And yet, he tells us that he's still on a journey. Confined as he is, he's still on a journey. I press on toward the goal for the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. He's moving forward. He's traveling toward a goal, the goal of heaven. And even in those close confines of his little cell, he's still a man on the road. His traveling days are not over. The journey goes on until we reach the destination of heaven. And you and I are on that same journey. Even if we never get off of Long Island, and let's face it, it is hard to get off of Long Island. Even if we never get off of Long Island, we're on a journey. We are pressing on. We are straining forward, moving toward the great goal of eternal life. And that is a lifelong journey. The earliest name for the Christian faith was the Way, which can also be translated as the Road. So our faith is a road. It's the road by which we make our journey to heaven. And remember, too, something Jesus once said. These are words that I often read at funerals. In my Father's house are many rooms. I go to prepare a place for you, and you know the way to where I am going. And Thomas said, Lord, we don't know where you're going. How can we know the way? And Jesus said, I am the way. So Jesus is the road. If you belong to Jesus, you are on the road. You are on a journey. And he is the road. And the journey he's taking you down is the journey to the Father's house. So we keep pressing on. We keep moving forward. You know, I mentioned Bob Dylan earlier. He wrote a lot of songs. Dylan did about traveling down the road. But when he became a Christian in the late 1970s, and alas, he was not a Christian very long, about 2.5 albums worth. But when he became a Christian, he wrote a song based on this lesson from Philippians. Pressing on and on and on and on, pressing on to the higher calling of my Lord. And that struck me as kind of a powerful thing. This man who had written and sung so eloquently about the road was now writing about the most wonderful road of all. And that's a reminder to me, actually, that all of those road themes, whether it's Don Quixote and Moby Dick, or whether it's Route 66 or Highway 61 or Easy Rider or the Road to Mandalay or anything about a road, every story and every song about a road is really a reminder of the greatest road of all. The road that we are on, the road that leads to the beauty of heaven. Now, what does this theme of the road teach us about life? First of all, it tells us that this life is not going to be perfect. When you're on the road, things are not perfect. Sometimes you end up sleeping in cheap, uncomfortable motels. Sometimes you eat sketchy diner food on the road. Sometimes you use plastic forks instead of elegant silver. Sometimes you eat on your dashboard rather than on an oaken dinner table. Life on the road is not perfect. Neither is this life that we're in perfect. We're on the way to heaven, but we're not there yet. So sometimes life is not going to be perfect. There's going to be heartbreak. There's going to be disappointment. We are moving toward absolute joy, but until we arrive there, we are liable to taste some bitterness and some sorrow. That's just the way it is on the road. When we arrive at our destination, we are going to walk on streets of gold. But right now, it's the grime and the grit of the road. We can't expect it to be perfect. And then forgetting what is behind and looking forward to what is ahead. When you're on the road, you keep your eyes forward. You keep your eyes forward. Remember what Satchel Paige, the great pitcher, said. Don't look back. Something might be gaining on you. See, we don't look back on the mistakes and the heartaches and the sins of the past. We keep our eyes forward. The great blues singer Robert Johnson had a haunting song that went like this. I gotta keep moving. Blues falling down like hail. Blues falling down like hail. And the day keeps on worrying me. There's a hellhound on my trail. Hellhound on my trail. Robert Johnson in that song had to keep moving because there was something chasing him. Something scary, something demonic. And in a way, there's something chasing us too. The sins, the mistakes of our past. St. Paul felt that because he had persecuted the church. He held the coats when they were stoning St. Stephen to death. He had a lot of bad stuff in his past, and it was kind of chasing after him too. But we don't turn around and look at those things. We don't obsess over them. We know they're back there like that hellhound, but we keep moving forward. And if we keep moving forward, then those things from the past cannot bring us down. As long as we keep our eyes forward, we're going to keep ahead of the past. And as we think about our journey, we remember the journey that Jesus took. He came down from heaven to earth for us. That's quite a journey. And ultimately, he shouldered his cross and walked the road of sorrows to Mount Calvary. And that's quite a journey. So Jesus traveled the road, traveled it for us, traveled it all the way to the cross. So when I need strength for my journey, I lift my thoughts to what he did, his journey. When I have to walk a hard road, I want to remember the hard road that he walked. And thinking of that keeps me on the road and keeps me pressing on. There is a great quote from Blessed Martin Luther, our father in the faith, about how this world is like a journey. And Luther writes, this life, therefore, is not righteousness, but growth in righteousness. Not health, but healing. Not being, but becoming. Not rest, but exercise. We are not yet what we shall be, but we are growing toward it. The process is not yet finished, but it is going on. This is not the end, but it is the road. All does not yet gleam in glory, but all is being purified. We're on the way, but we're not there yet. But as the great hymn we sang a few moments ago says, every evening we complete a day's march nearer home. A man once visited an elderly woman who was confined to her house. And he said to her, you must get sad and lonely sometimes being stuck here in your house. And she replied, I'm not stuck anywhere. I'm on a journey. She understood. She understood that not every journey is physical. She understood that she was on a spiritual journey. That living with God is a trek. And we're all traveling. And while sometimes the journey is hard, we also want to remember that it's a journey of joy. On the road again. I just can't wait to get on the road again. Jesus is our companion. Jesus is our road. And that means that our journey through life is a blessed journey indeed. The Cunard ocean liners, the ships that took people to Europe and back, they had a great motto that I think is true of the Christian life, the Christian journey. Although on Cunard they never had plastic forks, I'm sure. But Cunard used to say, getting there is half the fun. Getting there is half the fun. And may that be true of our journey. And may we be blessed with joy as we travel through life with Jesus. And glory to Jesus, our Savior. Jesus, our road, now and always. Amen. And may the peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and your minds in Christ to life everlasting. Amen.